Well, good morning, everybody. It's me, Mitch. And it's a beautiful morning as usual, and I'm out here. My morning ritual of getting my feet planted firmly into the earth and taking off my glasses and letting the sun shine in my eyes. I love this. It feels good. It feels good. And what I want to talk to you about this morning is something that I rank right up there in importance. Something that I think screws up a lot of people. I seem to focus on those things that make the failure rate of people who want to do this carnivore lifestyle so high. I mean, what good is it? What good is it to learn everything you need to do to get all excited about improving your health? What a few major misconceptions or lack of understanding of what it is that's driving your addictions just keep you on that roller coaster like I was on for like 50 years because they were my misconceptions and my motivations. And the title of this video asks you a critical question that I think most of us never even thought about. We watch all the videos about carnivore. We hear all the success stories. Why would anybody want to do this? That's where I think the problem is. We all have our reasons. We wouldn't be here looking at carnivore videos. We wouldn't be investigating this. We wouldn't be thinking, even contemplating making such a radical change, not only in our diet, but in our entire life, in our lifestyle. We didn't have a driving reason. Some people refer to this as, what's your why? Well, we all have to have a why to get out of bed. And I think where most people go right off track, right from the very beginning. And if you ask, if I were to ask 1,000 of you watching this video right now, who aren't carnivore yet, but have come here investigating, doing a little research, trying to figure out if this actually does work, if it is actually good for you. And most importantly, and I think of the 1,000 of you that I might ask, I think all, and you can disagree with me on this, but I think maybe all, but fewer than 50, and I think that's being generous, fewer than 50 of you will tell me, I want to lose weight and look better. And that's not only true of carnivore. That's true of any diet. And that's why people selling you diets and selling diet plans are selling you weight loss. That's all they talk about. Nobody sells better health. They sell, look how good you're gonna look when you lose weight. It's all about, it's better to look good than to feel good. So we all enter into this brave new world of changing our entire life so that we can look good. And I understand that. It's important to look good. It's important to be attractive. That's a very natural thing. That's how you attract a mate in nature. But it's the wrong reason. It's an inconsequential reason. It's a reason that doesn't mean anything. Oh yeah, it's great to lose weight, and it's great to become more attractive. But how do you measure that? How do you judge your progress? How do you gauge whether this new lifestyle that's disrupted your life in so many ways, how do you gauge whether it's working or not, whether you should continue it or not? And believe it or not, everybody who is, quote, on a diet has to reevaluate, and they do, sometimes many times a day, and compare the disruption, and depending on what diet you're on, the torture you're going through, with the results you're getting. And where do you get those results? Well, you either see them in the mirror, or you more than likely get them on the scale every morning. And that is where almost everybody fails. Because when you step on the scale, your hopes are so high. Man, I exercised so hard yesterday. I didn't eat anything yesterday. I should have lost a lot of weight overnight. And you step on the scale, and you didn't lose any weight. You don't think about everything else involved. You especially don't think about, is this going to improve my health problems? Is this going to get me off prescription drugs? Is this going to take my pain away? Is this going to make me feel better? Is this going to reverse my diabetes? No. No. You say to yourself, this ain't working. And you head right out to get your donuts and your ice cream. And that's it. Case closed. And then you run around telling everybody, I tried that carnivore thing, but that didn't work. I did it. I hung in there for 10 whole days and I didn't lose any weight. It didn't work. You won't admit to the fact that maybe you really didn't do it right, or you cheated a little bit. We all want instant gratification. Tell me what I can do now. That's why these very, what I consider, dangerous injections of GLP-1 agonists that people are taking are so attractive. Magic pill. Magic pill. Well, I'm here this morning to tell you why that is exactly the wrong thing to do. Why, if weight loss and looking better is your goal, that you can't stop that from happening if you take this little bit of advice. You can take it or leave it. Like my shirt says, I may be wrong, but I doubt it. It's what, on the eve of my second carniversary today, it was August 1st, 2022, when I finally made up my mind, understood this simple fact, put it into practice, that I was able to succeed. And now, magically, I lost all that weight. I didn't kill myself with exercise doing it. I didn't track it minute by minute and agonize if it, in the last 24 hours, I didn't lose as much weight as I wanted to. I didn't set a goal. Those goals are generally unrealistic and only lead to disappointment. Disappointment leads to failure. We're too impatient. My advice to you is learn why this carnivore thing actually works. Learn why it does cure a myriad of chronic illnesses. It does take the pain away. It does reverse your diabetes. It does vastly improve every aspect of your health. You will feel better. All that stuff will happen if you stop, just stop focusing on your frigging weight. Forget about your weight. Just forget it. It's gonna take time. It took you how many decades to accumulate that weight? There is no magic solution to just lose it that doesn't have dire health consequences along with it or makes you miserable. It cannot be sustainable if your primary focus is that scale. What worked for me, I came to terms with a reality that I finally had discovered after enough research. That when you get healthy, and this is the key, when you get healthy, your weight will optimize all by itself with no intervention on your conscious part. You don't have to think about it. You certainly can't be in a hurry. But I'm here to tell you, and I'm living proof, that you do this, and while you're getting healthy, even if you don't even notice, your clothes will start to get looser. Your weight will decrease. You're just sabotaging yourself if you focus on it. Throw away the frigging bathroom scale for at least a month or two when you start this. Set in your mind that your goal has nothing to do with weight loss. That if anybody tells you you just need to work harder and exercise more to lose weight, they are sabotaging your efforts and dooming you to failure. And even if you do manage to torture yourself for a few months and lose 10 or 15 pounds, you will put that on so fast your head will spin and then more, because that is not a sustainable lifestyle for most of us. I can't emphasize enough the importance of what I've just said. If somebody says, why are you doing that radical, ridiculous sounding and dangerous, according to so many uninformed people, why are you doing that carnivore thing? They'll try to talk you out of it. Your answer must be, I'm doing it to fix my health. I'm doing it to lose my pain. I'm doing it to reverse my type 2 diabetes. I'm doing it to normalize my blood pressure. I'm doing it to cure my metabolic syndrome and insulin resistance. I'm doing it to clear my brain fog. I'm doing it because fueling my body properly is the only way the machinery will work properly. Well, what about weight loss? I don't give a shit. I don't think about that. And just concentrate on getting better. And an amazing, amazing thing will happen to you, like it happened to me. An amazing thing. Your body's weight will normalize to exactly where it needs to be. And when you're healthy, where your body weight needs to be is normal. You'll end up like I ended up at 138 pounds, give or take a half a pound every day, I've been at 138 pounds for well over a year now. I don't do anything to maintain my weight. I don't monitor it. I don't care about it. I do what I do for my health, and my weight takes care of itself. Get off the roller coaster of losing weight and getting prettier. It is the wrong reason to do this, and it is a reason that will only disappoint you on most days and allow your addictions to rationalize to you that it's okay to eat all that addictive food. You know it makes you feel good. You know how comforting it is. Stop listening to this nonsense. Take those prescription drugs. Put up with the pain and all, because you're not losing the weight. That is so important of a message to me. Whether it's important to you or not, only time will tell. If you're considering carnivore, the only reason you should consider it is to get healthy. Normalize your metabolism, normalize your body, let it function like it's programmed to function. Stop poisoning it. I hope this resonates with, even if it's just a few of you that have been struggling. I can tell you only from my personal experience that this was probably the only change in mindset for me that's gotten me here at my 2-year carnivorcery with no drugs, no injections, no conscious actions that I needed to take, no weight goals, a scale that I just consider now a curiosity once in a while. And I can tell you that after the 50 plus years of trying to do it the other way, that this absolutely works. Absolutely works. If you do it for the right reasons, and stop, for God's sake, stop worrying about how little you weigh and how good you look. The biggest major difference is after 2 years, my whole mindset as it relates to food has changed. I would no longer even consider eating all that crap that I used to not be able to live without. All of my addictions. And I get asked this many times, how do you deal with your cravings? I have none. I don't want that stuff anymore. My whole mindset, my whole physiology, my subconscious mind's programming has adapted to a healthier life with no need for the garbage food and the addictive foods anymore. It didn't happen overnight. It took a while. I think if I look back, it took maybe a year before those addictions stopped coming into my mind. But it will happen. If you heed what I'm saying and listen carefully to me, I know I'm making this video longer than it needs to be. When somebody asks you, why are you considering such a radical and what most people consider unsustainable lifestyle of avoiding all sugars, carbs, grains, seed oils, look them in the eye and say, the only reason I'm doing this is to fix my body, my metabolism, and my machinery and get healthy. I'm doing this to reverse my diabetes, my hypertension, and all those other things we talked about. Well, how are you going to lose weight? Your answer to them should be, I don't even think about that, because I know, based on the results of people that are giving me advice, that if I only have as my goal to normalize my physiology and get healthy, my weight will take care of itself. And there's a truth you can't dispute. You're not going to find very many true carnivores, if you can find any, that are obese, diabetics, with dementia, Alzheimer's, or any other chronic condition, even cancer. They're thin, they're healthy, clear-minded, loving life. You can have that too. Forget the scale. Just forget it. I don't know how else to say it. So that's it. Forget the scale. Now, remember, forget the scale. It's not important. Got it? Okay, now, take the rest of the day off. Forget the scale and eat meat.